Hello friends, in this video we are going to see a practical current source and how it is different than that of an ideal current source. So I am considering a current source of I ampere and a very large resistance connected parallel to it. I will name it as RSH. SS stands for shunt, means parallel. So this will be a practical current source. Now this practical current source I am connecting to a load resistor RL so that there will be some current flowing through the RL. I name it as IL, because of which I will get voltage across RL given by VL. So again VL equals IL into RL, but because of this RSH some current is going to flow through this. And I can say the current flowing through the RL is given as I minus ISH. Since RSH and RL are in parallel, that means fixed voltage being applied across them. So the voltage across this RSH is same as voltage across this RL equal to VL. So what I will do, instead of this ISH, I can write voltage divided by resistance. Now suppose I want to draw a VI characteristic. Again, the independent variable will be VL, and depends on VL, I will have IL. Had it given a simple ideal current source, the IL will be same as I. But because of this RSH, I can say IL will not be same as I, but some value we need to subtract from I, resulting characteristic like this. So there will be a drop in current, and that drop in current is given by VL divided by RSH. So depends on value of RSH, I can have the value of IL, which is no longer same as I, but it is always less than I. So IL will always be less than I. Ideally I want IL same as I. So in ideal case this term should be 0. When this term will be 0? If the denominator is infinite. So that results, ideally shunt resistance should be infinite in order to get IL same as I. But practically it is not possible. So practically I should have IL very close to I. So this RSH should be as high as possible. So I can say practically RSH should be as high as possible, so that I will get IL close to I. So in this particular video we have seen that the practical current source will have the current value along with a very large resistance connected in parallel to it. So henceforth we are going to consider this practical current source, and we are going to convert that into equivalent voltage source in order to solve a problem. Thank you.